instantaneous state estimation. In this exercise, we consider a tricycle-like robot represented by this picture, and we assume that we have a state model for the system described by this state equation given here. So we have the derivative of the state variable that are a function, analytical function, of the state variable themselves. So we assume that we measure x and y and only weigh x and y, no inputs. And from only x and y, we'll try to estimate all other state variables. We can also, we should be also be able to compute the input u1 and u2. So for this exercise, we assume that we measure the position fxy of the center of the robot. And what is important here is that we assume that x and y are measured with a very high precision. So there is no noise. And from this, we should be able to estimate x dot, y dot, x dot dot, y dot dot, so the derivative of the position. And from this, we want to express the other state variable, theta, v, and delta, as a function of all these derivatives. Oh, here is my system, my tricycle, the position. V is the speed of the front wheel. Delta is the heading of the robot. And theta is the heading of the robot. And delta is the angle of the front wheel. So from this, usually what we do, if we have this kind of system, usually with a Kalman filter approach, we assume that we have two inputs, u1 and u2. We have also a measurement, a vector of measurement y, which corresponds in this context to x and y. Okay. Take care, it's not the same y. And what we do usually, we build an observer like this, such as an extended Kalman filter. So we linearize this function, which is totally non-linear. We linearize it. And from this, we should be able to compute an estimation xy, y dot, theta dot, v dot, and delta dot. An estimation, so excuse me, hat, excuse me, it's not dot. And from this, I can have noise. So I can get some covariance matrix of all these quantities. So for this, I need to have an idea to apply extended Kalman filter. I need to have some covariance matrices for y, and I'll need also to know the inputs. In our context, it is different. I do not assume that u is known anymore, and I will assume that I have no noise on y. We have an observer. We want to build an observer like this. I enter x and y. I will estimate first. Since I know y with a very good precision, I can estimate x dot, y dot, x dot dot, y dot dot. And from all these quantities, I want to build something which gives me theta hat, v hat, delta hat. Oh, since I know the derivatives of x and y, I will assume this. I will not explain here how I can get them from the picture, but also from the equation, since this quantity is equal to this quantity. I can see that the tangent of theta is equal to y dot divided by x dot. So from this, I know that theta is equal to arctangent of y dot divided by x dot. So recall that I assume that these derivatives are known. I will differentiate this equation and I obtain theta dot equal, so I recall that the derivative of arctangent of a function u is equal to 1 divided by u square plus 1 multiplied by y, the derivative of u. So I will use this. So the derivative of this quantity, so the multiply, so I consider this one, will correspond to this quantity. So this is the derivative of the division y dot divided by x dot square, like this. And here I take this quantity, so u corresponds to y dot divided by x dot. So y dot divided by x dot square plus 1. Okay. So now I can assume that this quantity theta dot is known. Now I take again the equation of the tricycle given here and I obtain that first equation gives me that V cos delta is equal to x dot divided by cos theta, and also V sin delta is equal to theta dot. If I isolate from this equation V and delta, I obtain that V is equal to the square root of V cos delta square plus V sine delta square and delta is equal to arctangent of theta dot divided by x dot divided by cos theta. Okay. So since I from this quantity I am able to express as a function of x dot and y dot and theta dot, which is also known. So here I obtain square root of x dot square divided by cos square theta plus theta dot square, and this quantity here is known as a function of x and y by this relation. Okay, as a consequence, I have now, and it is the same also here. So now I can say that first I know theta dot as function of x and y in the derivative, but now it is also the same for v and delta. So I can consider that I have solved my problem. I have here a function such that if I give x, y and the derivative, I will obtain an estimation for x, y, theta, v, and delta. Okay. Now, if I derive once more this function, I will be able also to obtain the input u1 and u2 as a function of x and y and the derivative, but now will appear the third derivative of x and y. a consequence of this is that if I know the trajectory for the car, but only I know the position for each T of the center of the car, then I am able to estimate all derivatives until the third derivative. From this, I will be able to deduce the heading, the angle of the front wheel. I will be also able to estimate the angle of the steering wheel and also the acceleration, if the driver is accelerating or not. But of course, the strategy is only based off the knowledge of the derivative and is not able to take into account the noise we could have on the trajectory.